Good morning. Today I'll be continuing with the same chapter, chapter number 6, that is molecular basis of inheritance. In the previous session we discussed about DNA and RNA. DNA, it is said to be deoxyribose sugar and it is a double stranded structure. Coming to the RNA, it is a single stranded structure, and then we study two different types of RNA. One is said to be genetic RNA, so that it acts as a genetic material. Second one is said to be non-genetic RNA, it does not act as a genetic material. In non-genetic RNA, we already studied three different types: messenger RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomal RNA. So these three different types of RNAs synthesize from the DNA template strand in the nucleus, and these three now enters into the cytoplasm so that it helps in the synthesis of proteins. So today we'll discuss genetic code, also known as codon. So what is meant by genetic code or codon? The name given by George Gamow in 1958. So here genetic code means, we already studied this, this is a mRNA, this is 5 prime and this is 3 prime. So that here there is a presence of nitrogen bases. Here group of 3 nitrogen bases present on mRNA that codes for a particular amino acid, that is said to be, what do you call, genetic code. So what is meant by genetic code or codon? Group of 3 nitrogen bases that is found on mRNA that codes for a particular amino acid. Here we have 20 different types of amino acid, but we have only 4 nitrogen bases, that is adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. Why here you are uracil? Because this is RNA. In case of DNA there is a presence of thymine, in case of RNA there is a presence of uracil. So here we have 20 different types of amino acid, but we have only 4 nitrogen bases. So this is insufficient. Therefore, a group of 3 nitrogen bases that code for an amino acid, that is more than sufficient for the coding process of 20 amino acids. So here these are nothing but nitrogen bases, first letter, and this is horizontal part is the second letter. Again these are all said to be the third letter. So these are all nothing but combinations. So first letter, second and third letter, so that U. Like that UUC, like that UUA and UUG. Similarly here, this is this one, CC and U, first letter, second letter, last letter. Like that, this is first letter, second letter, last letter, A, U and U. Like that, so totally we have 64 different codons, that is more than sufficient for the coding process. So these are all nothing but possibilities. Now coming to the characteristic features of genetic code or salient features of genetic code, very important for the examination. Coming to the first point, genetic code is said to be triplet. As the name itself indicates, there is a presence of group of 3 nitrogen bases that can code for an amino acid. Therefore it is said to be, genetic code is said to be, or codon is said to be triplet. So what is meant by triplet? Genetic code is said to be triplet because there is a presence of, or the group of 3 nitrogen bases that can code for a particular amino acid. Therefore the genetic code is said to be triplet. Coming to the second point, genetic code is said to be nearly universal. Genetic code is said to be nearly universal, that means here particular codon is coded by particular amino acid in all the living organisms is the same. For example, starting from primitive organism, that is from bacteria, up to advanced organism, that is human being. So particular codon is coded by particular amino acid in almost all the living organisms is the same. There are some exceptionals. For example, in case of protozoa, mitochondrial codon, there is a slight variation. Therefore, I use the word nearly universal. So except these two, in all the organisms is the same. For example, this UUU, that codes for phenylalanine. UUU, that codes for phenylalanine, in all the organisms is the same. Coming to the third point, genetic code is said to be degenerate. Genetic code is said to be degenerate. That means particular amino acid is coded by more than one codon. For example, here phenylalanine coded by UUU and also UUC. This property is said to be degenerate. So what's meant by degenerate? Particular amino acid is coded by more than one codon. Best example is phenylalanine, that is coded by UUU and also UUC. Coming to the fourth point is, genetic code is said to be non-ambiguous. That means particular codon is very specific for the selection of amino acid. Best example is this AUG, that selects a particular amino acid, is said to be methionine in case of eukaryotes. Same AUG, that is initiator codon, that also selects formylmethionine in case of prokaryotes, so that a particular codon is very specific for the selection of particular amino acid. That property is said to be, what do you call, non-ambiguous. So coming to the first important point, genetic code is said to be triplet. That means group of three nitrogen bases that is found on mRNA that codes for a particular amino acid. It is said to be nearly universal. That means particular codon that codes for a amino acid in all the living organisms is the same, starting from bacteria up to human beings. Best example is UUU, that codes for phenylalanine. Third point is said to be degenerate. That means amino acid is coded by more than one codon. Best example is phenylalanine, that is coded by UUU and also UUC. Fourth property is said to be non-ambiguous. That means the particular codon that is very specific for the selection of amino acid. For example, this AUG, that is the initiator codon, so that it initiates the synthesis of proteins, and this AUG that selects methionine in case of eukaryote, formylmethionine in case of prokaryotes. Next, we'll move on to the fifth one. Genetic code shows polarity. That means here this is the 5 prime region and this is the 3 prime region. And here there is a presence of nitrogen bases. Towards the 5 prime region, there is a presence of starting point. this is the starting point. That means there is a presence of initiator codon AUG, so that it initiates the synthesis of proteins. And towards the 3 prime region, here there is a presence of ending point. Ending point. And this is said to be terminator codon. This is said to be initiator codon. This is said to be terminator codon. And here there are 3 examples: UAA, UAG, UGA. These 3 are said to be, what do you call, terminator codon, so that it stops the synthesis of protein. And here it shows polarity, that means it shows starting and ending point. Starting point, that means towards the 5 prime region there is a presence of initiator codon. Starting point, that best example is AUG. And towards the 3 prime region, there is a presence of ending point or terminator codon, so that it stops the synthesis of proteins, that is UAA, UAG and UGA. And here this UAA is usually or scientifically said to be ochre, and this is amber, and this is opal. Ochre, amber and opal. Coming to the next point, 6th point, genetic code is said to be comma-less. That means this is the 5 prime and this is the 3 prime. Here nitrogen bases, it should read without punctuation. That means it should read in a group of 3 like this, without any comma. Therefore it is said to be, what do you call, comma-less. Coming to the last point, genetic code is said to be non-overlapping. Non-overlapping. That means here 5 prime, 3 prime, and again nitrogen bases like this. Here it should read in a group of 3 like this. Non-overlapping means nitrogen base of one codon do not share with the nitrogen base of adjacent codon. It do not share with the nitrogen base of adjacent codon, and this property is said to be non-overlapping. 5th point is polarity. That means it shows starting and ending point. At the 5 prime region, there is a presence of initiator codon, so that it initiates the synthesis of proteins. And towards the 3 prime region, there is a presence of ending point, that is nothing but terminator codon, so that it stops the synthesis of proteins. And then it is said to be comma-less. That means genetic code is read by a group of 3 like this, without any punctuation or comma. That property is said to be comma-less. And the last property is said to be overlapping. That means nitrogen base of one codon do not share with the nitrogen base of adjacent codon, and this property is said to be non-overlapping. So now genetic code means a group of 3 nitrogen bases that is found on mRNA. And what are the properties of genetic code? The first is said to be, it is triplet. That means a group of 3 nitrogen bases that code for a particular amino acid. Second property is nearly universal, so that a particular codon that codes for a particular amino acid in all the organisms is almost, it's the same. There are some exceptions. And then coming to the next is, it is said to be degenerate. That means a particular amino acid is coded by more than one codon. Next is non-ambiguous. That means the particular codon is very specific for the selection of particular amino acid. And then it shows polarity. That means starting and ending point. Starting region, there is a presence of initiator codon, and here there is a presence of terminator codon. It is said to be comma-less. That means it should read in a group of 3 without any punctuation or comma, therefore it is said to be commaless, and the last is said to be non-overlapping. Nitrogen base of one codon do not share with the nitrogen base of adjacent codon. These seven properties are very important. Here we can see totally there are 64 different codon. Here you have to remove these three, because these three are said to be terminator codon, so that it do not code for any amino acid. So minus these three, it becomes 61 different types of codon. So that is more than sufficient for the coding process, because we have only 20 different types of amino acid. I hope you understood what is meant by genetic code and what are all the salient features of genetic code. It is said to be triplet, nearly universal, and then degenerate, and then non-ambiguous, and it shows polarity, commaless, and non-overlapping. Thank you.